It's a landmark ruling. A panel of judges in Indonesia says top government officials have failed to set proper standards to curb air pollution. Their negligence, the court says, is partly to blame for Jakarta's poor air quality, often ranked among the worst in the world. 32 residents filed the lawsuit against the officials, saying pollution is affecting their health, livelihood, and life expectancy.
If the defendants, who are also government officials, decide to appeal the ruling, they could continue with their negligence. It could put millions of people's lives at stake.
The citizens' lawsuit was filed 2 years ago against 7 politicians, including Jakarta's governor, Anies Baswedan. He's now been ordered to monitor emissions from old vehicles and trash burning. And the court says President Joko Widodo should strengthen Indonesia's air quality standards. It's a problem he has raised before. In 2019, he admitted pollution around Jakarta was out of control. He recommended moving the capital to another city to ease overpopulation, traffic, and pollution.
Ever since my daughter started kindergarten, she's been suffering from nosebleeds. Now I know this isn't normal. She's really sensitive to pollution, and those nosebleeds can last for about an hour, up to 3 times a day.
30 million people live in and around Indonesia's capital, Jakarta. An air quality report ranks it the 9th most polluted capital in the world. Such levels of pollution can reduce people's life expectancy by up to 7 years.
When I'm out in the city, I can see how much smoke comes out of our city buses. Maybe they haven't had an emissions checkup. A lot of the time, I have no choice but to inhale the terrible smoke, and it hurts my eyes.
Many people in the capital welcome tighter government restrictions to reduce pollution.
I hope everyone, including the government, will work something out. I support more regulations for vehicles and factories.
It's a legal battle for the right to breathe clean air, one that could set a precedent for other citizens and environmental groups. The focus now turns to how and when the new court-ordered measures will be implemented. Katia Lopez-Odoyan, Al Jazeera.